Welcome back to the Azure Enablement Show and our series on learning resources. I'm April Edwards, your host for the series. Now we'll continue our tour of resources ready to help you become a better Azure professional. So without further ado, let's head off to our first destination.
Coming up, we're going to Microsoft certifications.
Hello, my name is Sandra Marine, and I am part of the Microsoft Learning Organization. I am the go-to-market lead for Azure training and certifications.
Why should managers pay attention to certification?
Certification is important for companies because it's a key component of a learning culture, not only as a proof of people's skills and expertise, but also with real benefits. Certified employees are more productive, they are more efficient in their roles, and they bring more creative solutions to complex technical problems. And certified teams add value to the organization. They have increased productivity, faster troubleshooting, and fewer skills gap. And certification simplifies talent identification. They make the screening process easier when you are looking to hire new people or when you want to distinguish your own employees.
How should managers get started with certification?
It's important for a company to identify what their business goals are when it comes to digital transformation. And depending on what the business goals are, they can identify the right roles that they need. And with those roles, they will be able to identify the right certifications for the team.
What are some features that managers should pay attention to?
So companies should look for globally recognized and industry endorsed certifications. And they should look for certifications that demonstrate technical abilities and their willingness to embrace new technologies. And that's what they can find in Azure and in Microsoft certifications. Learning and certification help people to achieve more business value and to be more productive. And all these should be considered when a company is thinking about certifications.
What is one thing that managers might not know about certifications?
One thing about our certifications that probably is not widely known is that they are aligned to relevant industry job roles. We work very close with our customers, partners, with industry analysts to understand what the market needs, to understand what is the trend in technology, what companies are going to need in the future. And that is the way we design our certifications. So we are not just thinking on what it is today, but we are looking ahead or what is coming. And with that, we design our certification portfolio. So we are always ready to help your company be prepared.
Our next stop is Instructor Led Training.
Hi, my name is James Seymour. I manage the Azure Apps and Infrastructure Technical Content Team in Worldwide Learning.
Why should managers pay attention to instructor-led training?
I think the thing a manager should think about instructor-led training is the customizability. So not every manager is technical. Learning partners can customize that course to really meet your level and your needs and bring you up to where you need to be. I would also say that we can focus those courses so your folks don't necessarily spend too much time away from the office. They can be remote. They can be blended learning. They can really customize that learning path to meet your and your team's education needs.
How should a manager get started with instructor-led training?
Managers should get started with instructor-led training by talking to their local learning partner. That learning partner can help customize the curriculum to meet the needs of the manager or the manager's team. They can focus in on the right stuff at the right time so they can schedule around work events or work schedules and customize that learning path to really meet the needs and focus on the technologies that that team needs.
What are some tips and tricks you would give to managers?
I would say the biggest piece of advice I could give to managers, depending on what their technical background is to start with fundamentals. Lots of times managers don't have the technical acumen that their teams do. So starting with fundamentals can really give you a broad base of knowledge to then go on to get the admin or architect or whatever particular course that you're really interested in. If for their teams, though, it may depend on where they are. They could jump in at the admin, or sometimes even starting with Azure fundamentals does help a seasoned professional because it gives them the broad base that they don't always use every day.
What's one thing that managers might not know about instructor-led training?
I would say the thing that managers don't know about instructor-led training is you don't always have to go somewhere and sit in a room for 8 hours a day. We have customized training that, well, today it's largely virtual, but also can be blended learning. So you can do some self-paced study, then go into a classroom, virtual or in person. It can also be scheduled around your particular environment. You could do night classes for a day shift or day classes for a night shift. Whatever it is that's needed for your particular environment is the local learning partners can really customize it.
Next, we visit Microsoft Docs.
Hi, my name is David Berry. I'm a program manager in Microsoft Docs for Azure Developer Experiences.
Hi, I'm Ornella Altunian. I'm a content developer for Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code.
What is Microsoft Docs and how should a manager get started with it?
So Microsoft Docs are a one-stop shop for all Microsoft products and services. And this content is built by the product managers and engineers and content developers who actually build the product. So you really can't get more official than that. And if you go to our page, you'll see a documentation section. And this will bring up a huge product directory of all of the things we offer. For example, if you want to look at Azure, then you'll be taken to all of the Azure products. And each one of these has its own table of contents with a lot of content. So there's reference content, tutorials, quick starts, all of these different types of ways that you can learn. And so for products that have multiple versions, so for example, if we go to something like Visual Studio here, you'll see that if you click on any content, in the upper left-hand corner, you'll get a version picker. And so you'll be able to see that same content for multiple versions of the product.
What are some tips and tricks for using Microsoft Docs?
Something that a lot of people don't know about is that you actually can download our docs as a PDF. And where you do that is down here in the lower left-hand corner with this download PDF link. This is something I've used before when I've had a flight that I'm getting on or I'm not going to have Wi-Fi access. If there's a technology that I want to brush up on, I'll download the entire doc set as a PDF onto my tablet, and then I'll have some reading material for those times that I don't have Wi-Fi or connectivity. Another thing that a lot of people don't know about our docs is that all of our docs are open source, meaning that if you, as a member of the community, see something that's wrong, like a spelling or a grammatical error, or maybe you read something and you feel like, you know, this could be explained a little bit more clearly, you can actually go in and you can actually make that change yourself. And the way you do that is by going up here to the edit button once you're signed in to Docs. And that actually will take you to a page where you actually can edit the actual doc in Markdown right in the browser. You make your edits, those will go to the content developer that's responsible for the page. They'll look over those edits, they'll, within a couple of days, approve those edits, and then those will actually be part of the live doc set. And so this is a great way that if you want to, you know, help out the rest of the community by improving the docs, you actually can do that very easily right in the browser.
How does Microsoft Docs help people succeed?
So when I think about how does Docs help people succeed, if you look through our docs, through all of our quick starts on our tutorials, we have a lot of sample scenarios and a lot of sample code that are built in there. And those can get you experience actually building something with our products and our technologies. But they also can provide the basis for the things that you need to build yourself. You can take some of that sample code or some of those commands right out of the document and then use that to form your solution. And that really can speed up your success when using our products and using our docs.
Coming up, we visit GitHub.
Hi, everybody. My name is Dave Burnison. I'm a technical advocate with the GitHub and Azure DevOps team.
Why should managers go to GitHub?
Managers should go to GitHub and learn about GitHub because it has expanded beyond just source control and simple issue management. GitHub's mission is to become the home for all DevOps tools, everything from source control, security management of your code, continuous integration and continuous deployment, and so much more. So you can use GitHub instead of so many different tools for all of your DevOps needs.
How should managers get started with using GitHub?
A manager can get started using GitHub by going to both Microsoft Learn and GitHub Learning Lab and look for the learning paths and modules to help you get started and understand all of the various tools, all the various DevOps tools that are available for you and your team in one place.
Are there any GitHub features managers should pay particular attention to?
Managers should pay particular attention to the following areas in GitHub. Issues and projects for managing all the work, all the user stories and things that their teams are working on. They should also pay particular attention or dive in and learn about GitHub Actions so they can take part in managing the flow from source code to dev environment to test environment to production, and probably even participate in the approval process that goes along with deploying solutions to production.
What's one thing that managers might not know about GitHub?
Managers may not know that GitHub has expanded beyond just simple source control and simple issue management in the last couple of years. And it's becoming the one suite for all of your DevOps tools, including things like security scanning your code, workflow automation for continuous integration, continuous delivery, and all flavors of workflow automation. GitHub's mission is to become the home for all of your DevOps tools. By learning about all of this, you can learn how to use DevOps as your assembly line. I always say that DevOps is to software development what the assembly line is to automobile manufacturing. But it's even more. It also includes the logistics to get software to end users, like delivery logistics, get vehicles to dealers. So if you can set up a secure, efficient, robust, resilient assembly line for your software solutions, you will innovate faster than your competition.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning Resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visited in this video, please check the text in this video's description. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.